Welcome back everyone to another very beautiful chess game by Paul Morphy. And in this chess game, Paul Morphy is playing with Denis Julien, and Morphy surrendered one of his knights. He sacrificed his knight before the game. This is a Knight Odds game by Paul Morphy from New York in 1859. So, as you can see in the chessboard, Paul Morphy is playing with the Knight Odds, a huge disadvantage for White. And Paul Morphy starts the game with playing e4. Denis Julien played e5, knight to f3, d6, d4, e takes on d4, bishop to c4, knight to c6, c3, knight to e5. Attacking the bishop, Morphy played knight takes knight, d takes on e5, and queen to b3 by Paul Morphy. And in this position, as you can see, Paul Morphy is attacking on f7, defending with the queen, f4, d takes on c3, and Morphy didn't capture the pawn, and Paul Morphy castled. c6, and Morphy captures the pawn, f takes on e5, again. The pressure is on f7, and now after capturing the pawn, Paul Morphy opened the file for the rook, targeting on f7. So, Denis Julien is defending with the bishop, bishop to e6, and Morphy captured the bishop, bishop takes on e6, f takes on e6. So, if queen takes pawn, queen takes on b7, that was the threat. And what would you do in this position? Well, Paul Morphy played bishop to g5, sacrificing the bishop, attacking the queen with the bishop. What a move by Paul Morphy. And in this position, Denis Julien captured the bishop, queen takes on g5. And after queen takes on g5, Morphy captured on b7 with the queen, attacking the rook. If trying to defend the rook, let's say if rook to d8, then queen to f7, and that's checkmate. Also, if trying to defend the rook with the queen, let's say if queen to d8, then queen to f7 again, we have checkmate. So there is no defense. You can't defend the rook. Denis Julien played bishop to c5, that's check, king to h1, queen takes on e5, and Morphy captured the rook. Queen takes on a8, that's check, king to d7, queen to b7, check, blocking with the queen, rook from a to d1, that's check again, blocking with the bishop, and now, this is one of the critical moments of the game. Paul Morphy played a key move, and after that move, Julien is losing, there is no defense for Denis Julien. So can you guess the next move of Paul Morphy? So in this position, there is a winning move on the spot. And after that move, there is no defense for black. So also finding the next move is also very important. So what would you do in this position? Well, if you are ready, let me show you the move. Paul Morphy played rook takes on d6, sacrificing the exchange. So black can't capture the rook with the queen. The queen is pinned. The only move, king takes on d6. So instead of capturing the rook, if king to somewhere else, queen takes queen. And black is losing the queen at the game. And Morphy played rook to d1. And Julien resigned. So you see why Paul Morphy sacrificed the rook like a maniac and then crushed his opponent. This is why, after this move, Denis Julien resigned. And let me show you the possible continuation. If king to e5, then queen takes queen. There is no other different scenarios. Black is losing the queen, and black is getting checkmated in a very short time. There is no defense for Denis Julien. So this is why, as you can see, Paul Morphy sacrificed the exchange after king takes on d6. We have rook to d1, and Julien resigned. Another marvelous chess game by Paul Morphy. He He simply destroyed his opponent after sacrificing the knight before the game. He was playing with the knight odds. Please don't forget that. So this was also a very elegant chess game by Paul Morphy. Also a very instructive chess game. So I hope you have enjoyed watching this video, and I hope to see you next time. Take care and bye-bye.